Actor James Gandolfini's death from a heart attack on June 19, 2013 shocked many. He died at the age of 51 while on vacation in Rome to attend the Taormina Film Festival in Sicily. Tragically, that trip would be his last, and all that he had worked on in his illustrious career would morph into a bittersweet legacy. Gandolfini is best remembered for his role in the iconic HBO series, The Sopranos. He played mob boss Tony Soprano on the show, which won him 3 Emmys, and according to Deadline, the actor cashed out $1 million per episode. After he died, HBO told the outlet that it would honor Gandolfini's death with a card for an episode that aired on HBO's signature at the time. The network said in a statement, "We're all in shock and feeling immeasurable sadness at the loss of a beloved member of our family. He was a special man, a great talent, but more importantly, a gentle and loving person who treated everyone, no matter their title or position, with equal respect." Gandolfini's presence and contribution to TV commanded attention, something he repeatedly reinstated with his role in The Sopranos. Despite all the posthumous respect HBO showered on him, they were apparently not very happy with the actor's habits and were even concerned about him before his death. In the book Tinderbox, HBO's Ruthless Pursuit of New Frontiers, journalist James Andrew Miller had much to share about HBO's journey with some of its iconic shows. Miller revealed in the book that former Time Warner CEO and chairman and HBO head Jeff Bukas expressed concern about James Gandolfini's health. Bukas claimed, "We were concerned about Gandolfini staying alive. Occasionally, he would go on a bender or a coke binge. We had to stop production." He also explained how the show's productions were expensive and were often delayed. These delays were challenging for the other actors and affected everyone's schedules. According to Miller, Gandolfini would ensure that he'd always have something to keep himself engaged. For instance, he would bring a few bottles of, quote, good Italian wine for the team to drink before events such as the Golden Globe Awards. The concerns were plenty, but former HBO chairman Chris Albrecht, who was also interviewed for Miller's book, was less worried about Gandolfini's health. He revealed, "I don't remember us being worried he was going to die, but he became a real problem while shooting the show. It became a lack of respect for the other actors as well, so there were sort of problems that bubbled up."
What I've been through, it changed the way you think.
In his book, Miller revealed that Gandolfini was the, quote, dominating and irresistible star for HBO. With everything the actor brought to the network, concern over his health and behavior seemed inevitable. Unfortunately, Gandolfini experienced several health complications that may have contributed to his early death. One of them was obesity. According to a University of Glasgow study, obese middle-aged men are 60% more likely to die from a heart attack. Also, Gandolfini was known to have struggled with cocaine and alcohol use in his early life, which increased his chances of heart troubles. Heart complications are a major cause of death in the United States, accounting for 1 in every 4 deaths per year. According to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, around 660,000 people in the U.S. die of heart disease annually. Globally, cardiovascular diseases kill an estimated 17.9 million people each year. The leading causes of heart disease and stroke include physical inactivity, unhealthy diet, and harmful use of tobacco and alcohol, among others. 1/3 of these deaths occur in people under 70 years of age. Gandolfini struggled with his eating habits. According to the New York Post, the actor's final meal included at least 8 alcoholic beverages. A hotel source told the outlet in 2013 that he drank 4 rum shots, 2 beers, and 2 pina coladas at dinner with his son. He had the drinks alongside fried king prawns and a large serving of foie gras. The source noted, "Everything Gandolfini ordered was fried. Obviously, that's going to cause problems with your heart. We may have lost Gandolfini too soon, but his work lives on." If you or someone you know is struggling with addiction, please call the Substance Abuse and Mental Health Administration's 24/7 National Helpline at 1-800-662-HELP. That's 1-800-662-4357.